granted to whoever's willing to accept them in whatever form they will. So, if the individual is willing to accept them in the form of Mary, then the demonic spirit, as God will allow them, will appear to them in the form of Mary. So when an individual actually sees a vision of Mary, they're seeing a demonic spirit. She's a human being, or was a human being. She's died. She's passed on. So if it's not Mary, then who is it? It has to be a demonic spirit. And what did Paul talk about angels in the gospel? If I or any other angel come to you preaching another gospel, let him be accursed. He said not just him, referring to an individual, but he said an angel. What are demons? They're fallen angels. And they have their gospel that they are preaching. And sometimes it sounds similar to the gospel itself. It sounds similar to the Bible. But the devil likes to take the word of God and twist it just enough to make it false. And what are these visions of Mary are doing? They are preaching a false gospel. When they promote Mary and say to worship her, that's against the word of God. It is a false gospel. Sometimes they might not preach a gospel that's contrary to the word of God. We have one statement supposedly by her about good sisters, return and restore the commons. That's not necessarily against the word of God, but that doesn't mean that it is the word of God. Demon spirits will come to you in whatever form you will accept them. And as we've already read, that these are lying spirits because they are preaching a false gospel. And sometimes miracles take place at these sightings. Does the devil have any power to do miracles? He sure does, brother. In fact, there's a great miracle recorded that he hasn't even done yet. He is going to bring a man that seems to have been dead back to life. We find that in the book of Revelation, I think 13, when it comes to the Antichrist. He is going to have a wound like unto death, and it's going to appear as if he's been brought back to life, mimicking the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So the devil has power. There are even other cultures that I've read books concerning missionaries in other cultures that they actually ask the tribes people, why don't you bring your sick to the missionaries to be cured? Why do you take them to these heathen gods in these temples? And the response was, well, when you bring them to your missionaries, nothing happens. But when we take them to the heathen temples, things happen. The devil has power. He can do signs. He can do wonders. But that doesn't make him the God. He is not the King of Kings, and he is not the Lord of Lords. In the end, he is going to lose. But he does have power. And it's through this power that he can deceive people as well. That is why it's important for us to know the Word of God. We'll even talk about this in the future, I'm sure, when it comes to the gifts of the Spirit. The devil has a handle on the gifts of the Spirit. He can mimic them. If he wanted to, he could come into a church service and use an individual to give a tongues or a prophecy that might sound like the Word of God, but it's not the Word of God. Now, that is the cunning work of the devil right there. He tries to get as close to the Word of God with just enough of a twist to make it false, to make people believe, because he is a deceiver. What does the Bible say to him? State concerning him? That he is the father of lies. He is the king of them. He knows how to tell the perfect lie to try to make you believe it. And he's been studying you your entire life, and he knows your weaknesses. So he knows enough to try to deceive you. But it is up to us to constantly be on guard, constantly be aware that we be not deceived, that we can guard our salvation through the help of Jesus Christ. Also, By doing so, we will know the voice of God. Jesus said, "My sheep know my voice." There are three voices in this world. There's the enemy's, there's ours, and there's God's. And the more that we draw closer to God, the more that we'll be able to distinguish between the two, or the three. Also, when it comes to the Word of God, the Bible says that our spirit shall bear witness with His spirit. If it's false, something should trigger within us that something's not quite right here. Even if we call a quote-unquote gut feeling, that doesn't sound quite right. Well, then maybe we ought to step back and investigate a little bit. Because the Word of God will not return void. And it doesn't matter, even when it comes to the Bible itself, we can pick it apart, we can pick it apart, and we can pick it to pieces. And it doesn't matter how much we study with a fine-tooth comb, we will not find that the Bible contradicts itself in any way. But rather, time and time again, it will only prove itself more and more true. We are going to conclude here for today. Does anybody have any thoughts, any questions, anything they want to add? If not, let's just go ahead and bow our heads for service. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you all praise and glory for everything you've done for us and shall continue to do. Lord, we thank you that you're God who reigns on high and that there's none like you, Lord. Even right now, Lord, we rebuke every attack of the enemy that should come our way. We pray that you set your angels at the four corners of the property, above and below, that no attack of the enemy may penetrate. I pray that our hearts and our minds will be one mindset and one accord, that we may worship you in sincerity and truth, Lord, that the Holy Ghost may move, making himself visible if he so chooses. Even right now, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you anoint the song leader and the musicians, give them a special blessing as they lead us in the songs you have us to sing, as they praise you upon the string instruments, upon the vocal cords, anoint the pastor's mind and his lips to bring forth the words you have us to hear today, Lord. And I pray that our hearts and our minds will be plowed, that they be good soil for your word to fall on, Lord, that we may remember it throughout the week, but even greater than that, that we may apply it to our life, and that it will take root in our heart, Lord, that it may never leave us. We know that your word will never return void, Lord, but Lord, may it spring up on good ground, Lord, that we may even be more transformed into your very image. And we ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Yeah.